Hey guys, in this video I want to show you 3 professional music video transitions. The masking transition. First of all, you need an object for your masking transition. And I will use this pillar right here. And we want to mask out the left part of the pillar, so it's really important that the pillar is big enough. But for now I don't want to see the left part of the pillar, and that's why I go some frames to the left. Now go into the fusion page. After that, drag and drop a polygon mask into the node field. Now connect the polygon mask with the media in one node and go to your polygon mask and check the invert box. Now move to the frame where you can see the left part of the pillar for the first time. So in my case it's frame 377. So and now try to mask out the left part of your pillar. Okay, nice, now move to the next frame. Again go to your polygon mask and adjust the mask point so that the left part of the pillar is masked out. Now repeat this procedure till your object is no longer visible. Now go to your polygon mask and increase the soft edge a little bit. Then go back into the edit page. Drag your video clip one layer up and drag and drop the second scene under your first video. And I see I made a mistake, so go back into the fusion page. So go back to your start frame, in my case it's frame 377, and go one frame to the left. Then go to your polygon mask and drag your mask to the left. And now the masking transition is done. So now I will move on to the next transition, to the flicker transition. So first of all, search for the frame where the transition will happen. And now try to copy and paste your clip by pressing Alt and your left mouse button at the same time. Now go to this point where you can see the first frame of your second scene. Now cut and delete the left part of your upper clip. Then go 6 to 8 frames to the right. Now cut again your upper clip and delete the right part. And then you have to press right click on your upper clip. Go to change clip speed and check the freeze frame box. Now press change. Okay, and now go with this clip into the fusion page. Drag and drop a polygon mask into the node field and connect the polygon mask with the media in one node. Go to the polygon mask and check the invert box. Now try to mask out your person as precise as possible. So I masked out the person and again press the invert box. Now everything is done in the fusion page, so we go back in the edit page. Go to your upper clip, go one frame to the right by pressing the right arrow button and cut your upper clip. Again go one frame to the right and cut your upper clip and do this for the rest of your clip. And then delete every second frame. After that, highlight the upper clip and drag it to the left. And now the flicker transition is done. The paper rip transition. For this transition you will need some paper rip footage, which is linked in the description. So after you've downloaded this pack, import some transitions into DaVinci Resolve. And then drag one of them into the timeline. And now go with this paper rip footage into the color page. Here you have to press right click into this node field and add an alpha output. Then you have to connect this node to the alpha output and go to your qualifier. This should be this symbol. Now left click once into this blue or green area. Then you have to click this little invert button. And now go some frames to the right where you can see your transition. And now go back to your qualifier tab and adjust the hue, saturation and luminance so that this blue line is no longer visible. So when this is done, go back into the edit page. Now drag this paper rip footage to the left. Go highlight both clips and press right click. Then go up here to new compound clip and press left click. Click create. And again go with your clip into the color page. Now you have to create again an alpha output. And again connect this node with the alpha output. Now go to your qualifier tab and left click the green area. Again left click this invert button. And again adjust the hue, saturation and luminance values so that the green line is no longer visible. So if you are done with this, then go back into the edit page. Now here you have to drag the compound clip one layer up. Search for the start point of your transition. And move the other clip to the left. And yes, as you can see, the paper rip transition is done. So I hope this tutorial has helped you. If so, then leave a like or a sub to my channel. Go watch this video right here, click on my Amazon affiliate links, and thanks for your attention, stay creative and bye!